Hi, I am Dr. Vybhav Deraje. I am a consultant craniofacial and plastic surgeon at Aesthetica Veda, Bangalore. How is craniosynostosis diagnosed? Now, most times the diagnosis is just clinical. What I mean when I say clinical is it is enough if we actually examine the child and also ask some history from the parents about how things have progressed since birth. In addition to our clinical examinations, we still might have to do a few tests to confirm the diagnosis. The best test to confirm craniosynostosis is CT scan of the head with a 3D reconstruction of the CT scan. This gives us very detailed knowledge about how the anatomy of the bone is and how the sutures have fused according to which suture has been affected by craniosynostosis. Most of the single suture craniosynostosis babies will only require one CT scan to diagnose craniosynostosis conclusively. But sometimes in syndromic craniosynostosis or in multi-suture craniosynostosis, we might also need an MRI scan to see how the brain is doing. The CT scan is very good for us to know about the bone, but MRI can give us good knowledge about the soft tissue, that is the brain inside the skull. In addition to this, we also do an eye checkup to see how the optic disc is, because optic disc is like a window for us to see how the condition of the brain is. If there is a lot of pressure on the brain, it shows up as papilloedema on the optic disc. So we do an eye test for every patient with craniosynostosis. Now sometimes we might have a very minor doubt whether this is craniosynostosis or deformational plagiocephaly. In such scenarios, we might only do a skull X-ray to confirm whether it is a craniosynostosis or it is a deformational plagiocephaly.